When we think of capes, we usually think of superheroes. But during the month of Capril, a cape becomes a must-have fashion accessory for all of us regular people. It's all for an initiative called Capril, and take a look at how our team is getting in on the act. Bring them in. Wonderful for fat days, can I just say? The man behind all of this is caped crusader John Mert. John, welcome to the show.
Sarah, good day to you and good day, team. What wonderful attire you're wearing.
Talk to us, what is Capril all about?
Certainly, during the month of what was formerly known as April, people wear capes in ordinary situations to raise awareness of depression and anxiety and a bit of fun as well.
I believe you've received lots of photographs from people who are getting behind the whole idea.
Absolutely. It started off as a radio gimmick where people used to do it, let's say, over the photocopier. So we've got photos of that. People are trying the escalators, which is always a bit of a challenge. And, of course, good people on national TV like yourselves as well.
So it's such a terrific initiative. Where do all the funds go?
All the funds are being raised and given to Beyong Blue. No point in reinventing the wheel. We'll be giving all the funds over to Beyong Blue for them to continue their work during the month of Capril.
And, John, as you and I both know, all the best superheroes in the world wear capes. Obviously, I've come dressed as my own personal superhero, Pauline Hanson. So we thought we'd take a look at some of our favourites. Have a look at this.
They're calling for you, sir, but who's going to answer?
Obviously, you have just been corrected by our special guest star, Nicholas Hammond, that not all good superheroes wear capes. Spider-Man, obviously. That's awkward. John, what's your favourite cape? I'm a Superman man myself. I mean, Spider-Man. I mean, what's your favourite?
No, you're right. It absolutely has to be Superman because both yourself, Joe, and I like the mild reporter, the mild-mannered reporter who always seems to find the way at the end of the day.
I love it. Look at that. It's Christopher Reeve.
Oh, amazing. Now, how do you look good in a cape? I must say, I think Ita has captured it beautifully. Mm-hmm. Is there a key to looking chic in a cape?
Well, Ita is always fashionable, but at the end of the day, a towel will do. The point is to bring attention to yourself, and people that way will have a conversation and you can start talking about issues like depression. Mm. May I say, if you have a broken arm, people strangely ask, what's wrong with you? And it's obviously you've got a broken arm. Here's a chance to have a catalyst of a conversation.
Well, look, you can find out more information about Capril and Beyong Blue by going to the websites. John, I've got to say, people who are struggling with depression and who go and get help and ask for help, they really are superheroes. Thank you very much for joining us on the show, John Mert.
Thanks for your time, everyone.